Hello friends, hope you are doing well. I'm Dr. Milind Chinda, MD PhD from IIMS Bhopal. So in today's video, I just want to talk about why there is so many people failing PG entrance examination and why success rate is so low. So there are several factors that affect and why you need to focus on your studies and how a proper preparation can definitely fetch you your dream seat. So it, as I told you in earlier videos, that PG exam is a brutal race. The kind of PG preparation happens is a way you are trained like a monkey and then you are given a certain task and then you are just followed upon. So that is not how how you are going to win the race. You know, like over the last few years, the PG exam scenarios in India has completely changed. There are people who are following certain classes and there are so many coaching and so many material. There is so much of confusion in students' mind. There was already a lot of confusion that was there in students' mind. And now everything that all the people are doing, adding more and more confusion to the people's mind. So why I just want to tell you in this video, this is what my experience and I want to share you a few facts with you. And I will leave the decision up to you that how do you want to proceed further. So guys, I'm just going to talk about how should be your preparation. So as I said that PG preparation is a race. It's not a 100-meter marathon. So we have to be able to win this race. We have to go with the plan. So guys, when we are PG seat is a dream. And it is being sold in a very glorified package. So this dream of getting a PG seat is being sold to us in a glorified package at a different amount. And most of the students just fall for it. I have just one question to ask. There are 1,80,000 students or 1,60,000 students who write NEET PG entrance examination. But only few, even less than 5 or 10% students are able to get their dream seat. So why the failure rate is so high? I mean, it's definitely the number of seats are low, but why some of people succeed? Maybe 1,80,000 students, they are not preparing with the same intensity, but definitely there are, I think, 50-60,000 students who literally put everything, they do all that is needed, but why they fail? So reason is this race is misinterpreted by many. Because we follow what coachings and these all classes have been, you know, imprinting on our minds for so many years. So guys, I just want to tell you, when we start preparing for PG, there are different kind of students. So I'll just give you one example. So some students who are in Ferrari, so they're like already in the Ferrari car. So I'll tell you what it is. Second, some students are on super bike. So it's a race. So some people are Ferrari, some people are on a super bike. Then there's a third group who are in car. There are a fourth group who are on bike. And then the last group who are on cycle. So who are these students? So Ferrari is the students who joined their classes in like their foundation coaching and everything they have been doing. So they did their foundation course in their second year. And they have been doing their classes in second year. They have read all the textbooks. They're already ready for the exam. I mean, they have been like gold medalists in their UGs and they have been like very honest and very sincere students. So this is what they are. So when they start this PG race, like after internship, when they enter in the PG race, they are already well prepared. They already have this everything on their mind. So they are already in the Ferrari. The person who are on superbike, so these are the students who have read, who are also a part, I mean, maybe not the foundation course, but they started later, maybe like third year or fourth or in the final prof, they joined their classes. And this is when they started preparing for their exam. So they are like superbike. They also have the potential and the material, but they are a little bit less than this group. Third is students on a car. So these are the students who joined classes during their internship. Like, as soon as their internship started, they joined the classes. They did good live or online complete classes. They followed. They made their own notes. And they all, just followed it religiously and they're preparing them. Students who are bike are the repeaters. I mean, they had some knowledge given the exam, but they have read well, but not the plan was not very good. Or they had some lacunage in their preparation. So because of that, they could not get their rank. So they're like 40 to 50,000. And last is cyclists who woke up after NEET PG 20. I mean, who are starting like preparing from November, December, like who started in November after the INI result came, they're like, okay. And who are like after doing their internship, who have not done any coaching for now, but suddenly when exam was declared in March, they started preparing. So cycle means they have to read now, they have to do all the classes, they have to see all the videos. So there is a huge task for them. And just imagine everybody is running the equal race. I mean, everybody, what I'm trying to tell you guys with this example, that when you are starting your race, this is what your competition looks like. So you might be on the cycle, you might be on the bike, you might be on the car, but this is what you are competing with each other. So that is why you should have a proper plan. If you are on a Ferrari, see these people, they give a lot of GTs. Because they already have their base prepared. So they give a lot of GTs just for practice. They saw a lot of MCQs. So that is what they advise. And definitely they are not wrong because their subjects, everything is done. So they don't need to do a lot of things. Students who are on superbike, they're also in a similar situation because they will be solving a lot of GTs. And it will be helping them in getting in a cream layer, because they are the students who are in Ferrari and Superbike, they want to get into cream. I mean, the best college in India, like Maulana Azad Medical College in Delhi, like Delhi College, Mumbai College. They want to get into those best colleges of India. Now the students who are in car, bike and cycle. See the what is being told by the coaching or, you know, these classes, like constantly burdening you with a lot of tasks. I mean, there are some plans given by them. And these videos and these image-based questions and the material given by them, you know, the kind of material and notes. Definitely, this material is huge. If you have to cover everything, like so many modules, so many GTs. So what they are trying to make you is they want to make you Ferrari. They are not wrong in that. They want to give you the material that will make you Ferrari. But, you know, no matter how much you do in the modification in the car, you cannot become a Ferrari in so less time. You cannot compared to the people who have been studying for so many years. So what I'm trying to tell you here is the beauty of NEET PG exam is what 5 rank will get will also 300 rank will also get. I mean, radio seat can be get, both can get the radio seat. If rank 10 wants medicine, definitely rank 2800 can also get the same branch. So that's what I'm trying to do. We don't have to go in the top like 50 or 60. If you try to cover everything, all the plans given by the classes, all the modules, images, videos, everything, you know, so basically you are trying to run your car as fast as Ferrari and you are not going to make it. You are just going to, your car is going to burn. You're going to burn out and you will be so confused that you will not even know that where the race is going. So you end up even have a bad result than what a person on cycle will have. Similarly for the bike and the people who are on cycle, you cannot cover everything in a so much of time. Again, you are competing against the Ferrari and the material that you are getting is to make you Ferrari. And definitely in this time and so much of things, you cannot be Ferrari. So how can you win a race? Can you win race? Yes, definitely. And when I say winning a race is not being rank one, but getting a rank that will fetch you your dream seat. So what these people need to do, as I have said in my earlier videos also, I just wanted to put it in more perspective that you need to follow your class notes, your PYQs, that's it. So people who are on bike and cycle, if you really want that you should go for, I mean, if you get a good rank and that you want your dream seat, you don't have to go for everything. You don't have to go for everything that the other students are doing. You don't have to go through each and every lecture. You can just see the videos for the topics that are difficult. There's no need to solve so many GTs. These people are solving so many GTs who are in Ferrari because their base is perfect. The base is good. So that's why when you see their interview, they emphasize on solving more and more GTs. But if you don't know about the subject, how you will never get a good score in GT. And your GT is not going to reflect in the result. So there's no point. So read your notes well, do your PYQs, and make your car, bike, and cycle win the race. So you get your dream seat. This is the mistakes that is done by a lot of students and a lot of students out there. So guys, there are some golden rules which I want to share with you. First, I mean, just regarding to the PG race that I want to talk. So what are these golden rules? So first, just give me one moment. So first rule in a PG race, there are several rules. First is, if you let other people's opinion dictate the way you prepare, you will never grow. I mean, you will never grow. What I mean here is, if you are going to let other people decide like how other people are studying and how your friends are doing, you will never grow in your PG prep. It is going to be difficult for you to win this race, because this race is brutal, as I have said. If other people is they are studying something, and if you see me go itna pad raha hai and he's studying so much, so I should also study the same. You're never going to cover your things. So don't let anyone dictate what you're doing. Just make your own plan. There are a lot of people telling you, there are a lot of successful people who have already done it. Take a positive point from them and make your own plan. Second thing is, slowly is the fastest way. The fastest way to reach where you want to. So if you want to win this PG race, as I said earlier also, you have to do it slowly. You cannot rush. This is a competitive exam. The exam is easy. Only thing, the result is affected because you make a lot of mistakes. So read slow, read to understand, read to retain, and read to remember. Third is, surround yourself with the people who have equal goals. So always surround yourself with people who are positive and who give you positive vibe, not with the people who make you depressed, who tell you, no, it's difficult and Supreme Court is doing this and counseling is delayed, exam is not going to happen on time and blah, blah, blah. Don't let such people, you know, affect your morale. You have to surround yourself with positive people. Then apart from this, whenever you are preparing, see what happens when I was also preparing, there were a lot of factors that were affecting that, but like students who were always negative about their things, always about negative about their points, always negative about what is happening and happening around them. So definitely, see, there is a progress which only you can see. You have to appreciate that progress, because other people cannot see it. Maybe you'll feel okay, you are not able to, they'll tell you, "Are you have just read these books, you have to read that," but you have to assess your own progress. Five is, top of one mountain is the bottom of next. So whenever you achieve something in life, that is never everything, you have next big target to achieve. So when do write your NEET PG, as always say that I and I should always be your target. So don't just stop there when you're done. Try better every day. If you think that you have completed your portion for the day, or if you have covered your portion, try to add few things there. Guys, that's all I wanted to tell you, that, you know, in this brutal race, you have to always be prepared, always be on time. Don't follow the herd. You don't have to be same as everyone is doing. There is no formula, no secret to success. There is only thing, that is hard work, consistency, and determination of a PG student. We have also been there. We have gone through this process. I know there are a lot of things happening around which are affecting your morale. There are a lot of disturbing things happening. But you don't have to let them get into your head. You have to keep preparing. You have to follow. And the last, but not the least, I just want to tell you one very important thing, that, you know, there was a study done when they, there was just opinion. So there were two videos on the internet. So first video was about a billionaire driving his Ferrari. And second video was about how to become a billionaire. So these both videos are available on internet. So you know what happened? So the video in which the billionaire was driving his Ferrari, it had around 2 million views. And when there was a video how to become a billionaire, where he was taking a time to tell, describe the methods and all the things he did, they were having 220,000 views. So you know what is the problem here? What I'm trying to make a point, you know, whenever we have I have seen a lot of influence. There are a lot of people who have already cracked their PGs and they have their channel, and they're telling a lot of good things to students. But you know, be it a UG medical student or a PG medical student, they're more interested in afterlife, that what happens after cracking the exam, like after cracking PG. They're more interested in life in MBBS, like UG student. PG student are life of a surgeon, life of a derma resident. They're more interested in that. You know, these channels have, these videos are, I have a more view. You know, even if I talk about more channel, my channel, I have also talked about everything. I have told, I have given even detailed plans about how things help me. I'm not telling that you should follow that blindly, but ironically, the videos about NEET PG being postponed, then videos about, this has got the maximum views on my channel, like the controversial things like will NEET PG get postponed and what to do. I know there is a lot of anxiety, but there are videos about planning and everything, but hardly they get any views from all the, most of the users. I mean, they have the least, they have a lot of views, but not as many as these videos have. That is the problem with, you see guys, we are worried about NEET. Actually, nobody is, but I don't see a lot of people being really serious about their studies and their planning method. I know you should know a date or everything, but what is harm in planning the study? You have to be ready for the worst, even if it is March, or even if it is getting delayed. All the PG mentors like me who are helping students to crack, we have given these plans, even if it happens on time or get postponed, how can you make use of all these three exams that is happening with you? So you have to give more time for that. Watch my video or any other mentor that you find you're comfortable with and whose methods you are more comfortable with. You have to watch those videos. Don't watch video just for fun. Don't watch how PG resident lives their life or MBBS resident live their life. That is not going to give you a PG seat. So watch something that is, that you will be benefited from. You cannot become billionaire by watching how a billionaire driving his Ferrari, but how they did it. So spend time on that. I have released 85 plus videos on my channel. There are a lot of students who are PG students who are helping the PG aspirants cracking the PG. So watch their videos and see how you can grow and how you can become successful. So guys, that's all I wanted to tell you. So I know the time is challenging, but stay positive, and I wish you guys all the best. And if you have any doubt, let me know in the comment box. So guys, I wish you all the best and take care.